Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Babita and in this video I will be talking about styes. What is a stye? Why do we get a stye? How do we treat a stye? And what can be done to prevent the formation of a stye? A stye is an infection of the glands that are present in our eyelids. Our eyelids contain hundreds of eyelashes and these eyelashes have certain glands that are present at their hair follicles. These glands produce oil that keeps our eyelashes and our eyes moisturized. However, sometimes bacteria can reach these glands and they infect them. And this leads to the formation of a nodule that is filled with pus and we call that nodule a stye. Another name for stye is external hordeolum. So do you have a painful nodule at the margin of your eyelid? Does it look like it is filled with pus? Or is your eyelid diffusely red and swollen? And is your affected eye appearing smaller in size than your normal eye? Then in all these cases, you might have a stye and you must visit your eye doctor immediately. But how will your doctor confirm a stye? Will you do some blood tests or x-rays or even a biopsy? Well, no. A stye can be easily diagnosed on clinical examination, either on torchlight or by a slit lamp machine. Your doctor will not ask you to get any sophisticated blood tests or any x-rays done unless of course he or she is suspecting some other pathology. Getting an occasional stye is very common. However, in some cases, styes can be recurrent. Some people get styes at different locations every few months. And to treat such patients, we need to dive deeper and find out the reason as to why they are getting these styes again and again. So why do some people get recurrent styes? What can be the possible reasons? The first reason is poor lid hygiene. Some people have chronic infection of the eyelid margin. Some people have dandruff at their eyelid margins. Some people may even have lice on their eyelid margins. All these conditions fall under the category of what we call blepharitis. Blepharitis means infection or inflammation of the eyelids. And if you have blepharitis, you are very likely to get recurrent styes. So unless you treat your blepharitis, getting rid of styes becomes extremely difficult and we will talk about how to treat your blepharitis but in a short while. The second reason you might get recurrent styes is diabetes. Diabetes is a terrible disease that affects virtually every organ of your body. Uncontrolled diabetes, uncontrolled high sugar, lowers your immunity and increases your chances of getting a bacterial infection. So if you are an adult and getting recurrent styes, your doctor will ask you to get your blood sugar levels checked. And if your blood sugar is high, your doctor will obviously ask you to control it. Another reason of recurrent styes, especially in children, is frequent rubbing of the eyes. Sometimes when children cannot see clearly, they rub their eyes in the hope that it would clear up their vision. Their hands may be dirty and this transfers bacteria from their hands to their eyes, leading to the formation of a stye. So if your child is getting recurrent styes, there is a possibility that his or her eyesight may be weak and they need a more detailed checkup. So how do you treat a stye? Most styes, especially the small ones, they resolve on their own without any treatment. For other cases, depending on the severity of your condition, your doctor may prescribe antibiotic capsules and pain relievers. You will also get an antibiotic ointment for application on the lid. To reduce eyelid swelling, warm compresses are highly recommended. What you do is that, you dip a cloth in warm water, wring out the extra fluid so that it is not dripping, and then apply this damp cloth on your lid with your eye closed. Make sure that the water is not very hot, otherwise it might burn your skin. A stye is just like getting a pimple on your face. But this time the pimple is on your eyelid. And just like you should never pop a pimple, you should not pop your stye too. Styes do not need any kind of biopsy or surgical removal. Warm compresses and antibiotics are enough. And now coming to the most important question, how can we prevent recurrent styes? First, if you are a diabetic, monitor your blood sugar levels, keep your diabetes under control. Not just because you don't want a stye, but because you don't want any diabetes-related complications anywhere in your body. Second, get your eyesight checked to see if you need glasses. Third, maintain lid hygiene. Avoid the habit of rubbing your eyes. Never touch your eyes with dirty hands. This advice is specially meant for children. Do not share your eye makeup with anybody else because that can also transfer bacteria. In case you have blepharitis, you can use diluted baby shampoo to clean your lashes. Take 1 cap full of baby shampoo in 1 mug full of lukewarm water and dissolve it. Dip a small piece of cotton swab into it and then scrub your eyelid margin with this cotton swab. Do it at least 2 to 3 times a day for at least 2 weeks to get good results. In case your blepharitis is severe, your doctor will also ask you to apply an antibiotic ointment after doing these lid scrubs. Stye is not a contagious disease. If your child is comfortable, you can easily send them to school. Don't worry, it will not lead to a stye outbreak in their class. But of course, tell your child to keep their hands away from their eyes. Getting a stye once in a while is nothing to worry about. It sure is a painful inconvenience, but it does get better within 5 to 7 days. However, if you have recurrent styes, please consult your eye doctor to investigate the root cause of your problem. So that is all for this video. Please like and share this video with your friends and family if you found it useful. And please subscribe to my channel if you wish to see more such educational content. Thank you very much.